দর্শক শুভেচ্ছা, স্বাগত সবাইকে। আজকের চলতে চলতে অনুষ্ঠানে আপনাদের সঙ্গে আছে মাহফুজ মিশর। আজকে আমাদের অতিথি ঢাকায় পাকিস্তানের হাই কমিশনার জনাব সুজা আলম। হিজ এক্সেলেন্সি সুজা আলম, মোস্ট ওয়েলকাম টু আওয়ার শো চলতে চলতে। হাউ আর ইউ?
থ্যাংক ইউ, ভেরি গ্রেটফুল ফর দ্য ইনভিটেশন।
ইউ আর অলমোস্ট ইন দ্য লাস্ট টাইম ইন ঢাকা, দ্যাট মিনস ইউর ঢাকা মিশন ইজ কমপ্লিট অ্যান্ড ইউ আর লিভিং ভেরি সুন। সো ইন দিস টাইম, হাউ ইউ ক্যান ইভ্যালুয়েট হোয়ার আওয়ার রিলেশন স্ট্যান্ড রাইট নাও?
ওয়েল, I have, on the eve of my departure, I have nothing but fond memories of my stay here. It's been really a very pleasant and at the same time a very rewarding stay. The state of our relations are solid. I call them solid because they are rooted amongst the people of the two countries. Both the kind of love, the warmth, the sincerity that I've seen amongst the people of Bangladesh for Pakistan in general, Pakistan in particular, and the same kind of respect and sincerity you find in Pakistanis, and we really wish the best for Bangladeshi. So that is our strength. So I am quite sure that in times to come our relations will prosper because they are based amongst the people of the two countries.
But we have seen, if we compare the relation between last 10 years or 15 years and now, it's in a critical situation because all the world is now in a critical situation. At the same time, there are some problem raising between Dhaka and Islamabad regarding some staffs, regarding some activities. So it was a tough period for you?
No, I wouldn't call it tough. It's part of our job and we have to respond to the situation that arises. But at the same time, what is comforting and what is very satisfying is, the goodwill that exists between us. Yes, even amongst brothers you have a difference of opinion, but that doesn't mean that your relations are not on a strong footing. And I feel it's the same with between Pakistan and Bangladesh. Yes, we might have a difference on certain issues, but those issues should not reflect or do not reflect on the overall relationship between Pakistan and Bangladesh.
Have you taken any kind of initiative during your tenure to resolve the issues?
Well, you see, what we are hoping for, that hopefully we'll have the foreign secretary level talks very soon. I think it's up to the host.
At least two or three times that have been cancelled.
Yes, but they are because of previous commitments. They are this time, let the government of Bangladesh announce the dates because it's their prerogative. So I'll defer to that. But we are going to have it soon, and then we'll be followed by, inshallah, by the SAARC summit. So we expect to welcome your leadership to Islamabad, and I think that should provide the impetus to bring the two countries closer together.
Bangladesh became independent in 1971, but you recognized Bangladesh at least after 4 years, mm-hmm. after the killing of father of the nation, Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman. Some people said there is a conflict between with the Awami League leaders and with the Pakistan leaders.
No, Bangabandhu went for the Islamic summit to Pakistan. This was followed by, to normalize relations. And then this was followed by a visit of Zulfiqar Ali Bhutto back to Bangladesh. So that impetus was provided by Bangabandhu to normalize relations with Pakistan. So I think that, and then, unfortunately, the tragic death of not only Bangabandhu but his whole family was a huge tragedy. And since, but that impetus to normalize relations was during his lifetime that came about.
But why Pakistan didn't recognize Bangladesh before his death?
Well, you see, his death, we couldn't have predicted his death, but the mechanism for normalization had started by Bangabandhu, and it was this normal culmination that the relations became normalized. Yeah.
After the Gulshan attack, it's a terrible situation also here in Bangladesh, and you people also are worried, and you are facing this kind of terrorism from last couple of years. Bangladesh is facing very recently. There are some people who said there is a propaganda going on that Pakistan intelligence may have some connection with this kind of attack. How did you explain? Is IS and ISI became the synonyms?
It's just all these conspiracy theory and rhetoric, but nobody who understands a bit of international relations believes in them. our heartfelt sympathies and condolences for the victims, for their families. Our prayers are for the families, and Pakistan has condemned this incident unequivocally. And the fact is that, you know, Pakistan itself has lost almost 60,000 people to terrorism. So we understand the concerns of the government of Bangladesh to fight. We support their fight against terrorism wholeheartedly without any ifs and buts. And if there's any assistance that Pakistan can provide, we would be, you know, very, very supportive of that.
But during your tenure, some of your officials, some diplomats, some his officers, some taxation officers, they are also they have to go to the police custody, and there are some allegations that they have connection with the militant financing, and finally you remove them from Dhaka office.
Well, we rejected all those allegations. Our press release, our ministry's foreign affairs explanation is all there available for us. But that is an incident that is behind us, and we are looking forward to a much more positive relationship.
But don't think this kind of incident can make large gap between people to people contact between two countries?
Well, what I can say is that these incidents should not take place. There is no doubt about it. It doesn't behove two brotherly nations to come to an extent, but I am sure that now things will move forward, and we see a better understanding between both.
Excellency High Commissioner, don't you think it's your failure that during your tenure, your officials like Farina, like Abrar, they were involved in such kind of activities?
Oh, I've categorically rejected any allegation of their involvement at the highest level, I've told them. But yes, that incident happened, and we hope that the diplomatic norms between the two countries will be followed in future.
But then, why you removed them from Dhaka office?
Well, we were asked to get her back.
So, you are hopeful that this situation will overcome?
Oh, absolutely. I have no doubt about it, because you see, when relations are rooted amongst the people, then they're bound to be strengthened, and such small hiccups both countries would be able to overcome.
Okay, Excellency High Commissioner, we have a lot of questions to you, but before then we have to take a break. Darshak, chotto ekta biroti niche kotha bolbo Pakistan High Commissioner Shuja Alamer shonge amader shonge thakben nishchoy. দর্শক স্বাগত আরেকবার। বিরতির পর চলতে চলতে অনুষ্ঠানে কথা বলছিলাম ঢাকায় পাকিস্তানি হাই কমিশনার সুজা আলমের সঙ্গে। এক্সেলেন্সি, ডিউরিং ইউর টেনিওর ইউ হ্যাভ টু গো টু ফরেন অফিস সেভারাল টাইমস, বাট অ্যাট লিস্ট ফোর আর ফাইভ টাইমস ইউ আর সামন বাই দ্য ফরেন অফিস। হোয়াই অ্যান্ড হোয়াট ইউ সেইড ডিউরিং দ্য সামন উইথ দ্য ফরেন অফিসিয়ালস ইন বাংলাদেশ?
Well, I say because the foreign office likes me so much. That is why I am there every second time. I am, they serve me coffee and sandwiches. So I went there. But no, the issues.
That is a part, but there is another part.
Yeah, the issue was, of course, our differences on the International Crimes Tribunal. That was the reason that I was summoned that was the main reason that I was summoned.
So International Crime Tribunal is a national court, and they are doing the justice for their own citizen. So why sometimes your government, even in your parliament, they are so interested in this?
Well, I have explained, our government has also explained our policies on this, and it's all open in public domain. So I won't comment much on that. But what I'd like to say is that even amongst brothers, you know, you have differences. But I am sure there's enough goodwill amongst the people of both countries to overcome this. And I think our relations are multifaceted. They are not confined to a single issue. And therefore, we need to develop our relations in its whole spectrum rather than, you know, keep a focus on one single issue. And that has been our approach.
And you said there is a trilateral treaty in 1974, and after this you said there is no necessity of their judgment right now. That is your stand?
Well, yeah, I think the 74 tripartite agreement primarily governs all these issues, and that is our interpretation of that treaty.
But if that why that 195 people who are back to Pakistan from the independent Bangladesh, they also not going to court, they are not face the court, and they are not, their judgment is not yet declared.
There is no mention of 195 prisoners in the tripartite agreement.
So what about that 195 people? Would you make judgment for them?
No, but you see, once you read your own the history of Bangladesh, you understand where the figure of 195 came up from, and that would explain why or what has happened. So primarily, again, you know, that tripartite agreement was meant for a forward-looking approach, and this word is, I think, mentioned in the tripartite agreement, and that is what our endeavor should be, to look forward. If there are differences, yes, we can discuss that, but let's take a wholesome approach to bilateral relations. The world has moved on. There's so much happening. There's so much that the people of two countries desire to happen. I think us bureaucracies and the leadership as well, I think there is a greater understanding amongst the leadership between the two countries as well. And I think we should build on that and move forward, because if we move forward, I honestly believe the amount of goodwill that I've seen here, that sky would be the limit in our bilateral relationship.
But if you really would like to forward the relation, and at the same time, Bangladesh, many you have some stance, so is Bangladesh government doesn't like, Bangladesh people doesn't like, some part of people even claimed that to cut off the relation with Islamabad. So can you inform this situation from Dhaka to your head office, especially after the International Crime Tribunal activities?
Well, that is my job, to inform how the situation is developing, what the people's sentiments or the government sentiment is. That is my job to do that, and the High Commission does it very regularly.
What is your evaluation? What are the people's concern regarding Pakistan-Bangladesh relation?
Well, this is what I'm saying. The people have such a huge amount of goodwill for Pakistan, and I found the same amount of goodwill between Pakistanis for Bangladesh. We really relish your achievements in the social sector, in terms of women empowerment, in terms of health, in terms of education. You know, you have produced some of the most brilliant people, you know, who've changed perception of economics, Grameen Bank, and and then your NGOs, BRAC and all, their innovative approach to social issues, to healthcare, to neonatal care and all that. Your women empowerment, women in the economic force, you know. Plus, so all these issues, there's so much that Pakistan can learn from Bangladesh on this, which is why we need much, much closer interaction between the people, between NGOs, between governments, between non-governmental organizations, intellectuals. We have some of the finest research think tanks here in Bangladesh. They have so much to offer in terms of the analysis, in terms of their policy prescription. And I think these are the areas where we need to concentrate for the future. Because come to it, for a developing country, and now inshallah Bangladesh is already in a, you know, middle income and aspiring to be upper middle income country. These are the issues that an average Pakistani or every Bangladeshi confronts every day. You know, so fighting poverty, fighting disease, fighting destitute people and helping them, that should be the paradigm under which our two countries should cooperate, and that probably is the desire of the people.
Obviously, that is the desire of the people. But Is Pakistan government prioritize these issues between the relation, or sometimes they only interrupt in the Bangladesh internal matter?
We have no interest in your internal matters, because Pakistan, when I came here, my instruction from the Prime Minister and the President, from the leadership, was that, listen, Pakistan's priorities are economic development domestically, to work for the welfare of the people. And for this, it is critical, really critical, that we have good neighborly relations in the region. There should be peace in the region, and we should have the best of economic trade relations. So that is my mandate, and that will be the mandate of my successor. So yeah, Pakistan is open to cooperation in all the social sectors, economic sectors, to work to the benefit of the peoples of both countries.
Yes. Excellency, again, we have to take a break. Darshak, ke porje abaro chotto ekta biroti, fifth chapter por amader shonge thakben nishchoy. দর্শক স্বাগত আরেকবার। চলতে চলতে অনুষ্ঠানে আমরা কথা বলছিলাম ঢাকায় বিদায়ী পাকিস্তান হাই কমিশনার জনাব সুজা আলমের সঙ্গে। এক্সেলেন্সি, ইউ আর ভেরি মাচ ইম্পাসাইজ অন পিপুল টু পিপুল কন্ট্যাক্ট বিটুইন টু কান্ট্রিজ, অ্যান্ড ইফ ইউ আর অলমোস্ট ওয়ান অ্যান্ড হাফ ইয়ার হেয়ার অ্যান্ড ইউ হ্যাভ সিন মেনি থিংস, মেনি প্রসেশন, বাংলাদেশ পলিটিক্স অ্যান্ড দ্য সাইকোলজি অফ বাংলাদেশ পিপুল, অ্যান্ড অবভিয়াসলি ইউ উইল বি অ্যাগ্রিড উইথ মি দ্যাট মোস্ট বাংলাদেশি পিপুল ওয়ান্টস গুড রিলেশন উইথ পাকিস্তান, বাট there are some but and they demand a official sorry from your government, because we have a bad past. In 1971 there are a lot of clashes, and at least many people died here in Bangladesh, and Bangladeshi people knows that it was done by your army or your that time leaders. But now the Pakistani people and Bangladeshi people, if really want a good relation, then a sorry is mandatory on behalf of Bangladesh people. What's your evaluation regarding this?
Well, first of all, I agree that there is a lot of goodwill between the people of Bangladesh towards Pakistan, and it's sincere, and from the way I see it, there are no ifs and buts. Yes, there are certain issues they would like to be resolved, and this is what I said. You know, even amongst brothers, if you have differences. And I can say it with quiet conviction that every issue between the two countries can be resolved, provided we go for a sustained, a contact with each other, sustained interaction with each other. Let the whole of the society come and meet each other. Our intellectuals, our historians, our civil people, sector people. Non-governmental organization, people working in the social sector, and then you can have a holistic view of the relations. But if there are any concerns of the Bangladeshi people, Pakistan would be ready to address them. But it has to, you have to show the will to move, one has to show the will to move forward, and then every issue has a solution. I doubt there's any issue, especially when you have so much convergence amongst the people, that you cannot resolve.
But it's almost 45 years, and you said brothers might have some conflict, some misunderstanding, but it's very much easy for a brother to say sorry to another brother. See, why that doesn't happen, which can make the relation very easy going?
45 years is a blip in history, you know. It's a very, very small time. Bangladesh probably would be one of the youngest nations in the world, barring a few that came after 1989. So in terms of history, in terms of our interaction, our relations go back to thousands and thousands of years. So 45 years is just a couple of generations ahead. But like I said, there is no issue that cannot be resolved, provided we have the will to continue to move forwards, and solutions come out through interactions. They cannot come out in isolation. So I hope the foreign secretary level talks and the SAARC summit would provide an opportunity to bring the two countries closer together, and reflect our relations that are commensurate with the will of the people in both countries.
You know, in 1971, when Bangladesh was a part of Pakistan, lots of oils like National Bank Reserve, Bangladesh Bank Reserve. At that time it was East Pakistan Bank, jute, and many other oil was going to that Pakistan at that time. And Bangladesh, if Bangladesh claimed that wealth now, what would be the process?
Well, it is part of our, you know, there have been discussions on this issue since the two countries recognized each other. And we can have discussions. They are complex. There are no easy solutions in terms of, I think you're talking about division of assets and all that. You see, again, they can be discussed. All complex issues also have a solution, to understand both sides' point of view, and then move forward to an acceptable solution that is, you know, acceptable to both.
At the same time, are you really hopeful about SAARC? Because SAARC is not working effectively because of you and our neighbor India. That is your two countries' problem, but another six countries is also suffering.
All I can say is that our prime ministers, first and only focus is economic development in the country, and it cannot happen in isolation. It has to be a regional approach, and this is what he has adopted, you know, in terms of China-Pakistan economic corridor, our relations with ECO, and now we'll be members of SCO, and the same way in SAARC. SAARC is a huge potential region. I think its final distillation is a free economic trade, free movement of people across the border, greater economic integration. That is its future. And how we achieve that, and I also feel that this is the will of the people as well. So us bureaucrats have to come up with the work with solutions to realize what our populations aspire in this regard.
Some people believe that your government or Pakistani people allow the terrorists to use their lands in against of Pakistan, or sometimes they send their intelligence or some citizens in the land of Bangladesh to act against of Bangladesh.
No, you see, Pakistan has been really at the forefront of fighting terrorism, and our sacrifices, our efforts are second to none in terms of that. And we have achieved a sort of a complete national unity, consensus amongst the political parties, amongst the whole spectrum of our society, amongst all our organs of state in our effort to fight terrorism. And its results are for there to all to see. Our national action plan, the way we have fought Tehreek-e-Taliban Pakistan and completely eliminated them from our areas. The peace dividend is there for all, for people of Pakistan to see. And therefore, I think with Pakistan's experience, we are ready for any kind of collaboration, cooperation, assistance that Bangladesh needs. And I'm sure Bangladesh is capable of dealing with.
We are almost in the end of the program. I just want to say you again that question. Do you personally believe it's not the stand of Pakistan government or Pakistan High Commission or Pakistan Foreign Office, that if Pakistan will really regret for 1971, their role in 1971, and if they will say sorry to Bangladeshi people, then the relation could be much more easier?
Well, you know, as a representative of Pakistan, I have no personal opinion on this issue. So whatever opinion I express is the opinion of the government of Pakistan. And in that regard, you know, I would refer to, again, the tripartite agreement, which uses the word regret. I would refer to General Musharraf's statement when he came here. He used a similar word. But, and again, finally, I would say that, you know, no issue between our two. There is no issue that cannot be resolved between our two issues, countries, provided there is a will, a strong will, to move forward and reach a destination where we truly reflect the aspirations of the two people, our peoples.
Yeah, Christian, you know, International Crime Tribunal is also active and many judicial processes going on. So we have to have some punishment within few days or few months. Then again, we got same reaction from Pakistan.
Well, I cannot predict the future, so it would be conjecture if I talk anything about that at present. You know, your judiciary would take a decision, and just to see, if your question means that you already know what the decision would be.
One is in the highest court.
Yeah, but even then, let the judgment come out, and then yeah. We'll see.
If that happened earlier,
I can't reply to NF. You know, let that happen and then we'll see.
So you are leaving Dhaka very soon. What's your experience regarding Bangladesh? What good memories you are bringing to Islamabad?
I am so humbled by the sincerity, the love from the people of Bangladesh, the way they have opened their hearts to us, the way they welcomed us in their houses. The great food that you have, the great cultural underpinning of your nation, and the openness with which you meet, and your hospitality, that is the memories of me and my family, who had one of the best tenures in our career in Bangladesh. On a personal level, this is a place where I discovered golf, so I am at Kurmitullah Golf Course all the time, again meeting some wonderful Bangladeshis there. I've learned a personal skill that I'll brag about when I go back to Pakistan.
Thank you, Hakeem, and have a nice time. Darshak, shesh korchi aaj kotha hobe poroborti porbe notun kono tithir shonge, shei porjonto bhalo thakben shobai.